Happy day, dear all. Welcome to my English class. So in the previous class, we started with the new poem, The Sparrow. And we also completed stanza one and stanza two. So in today's class, we'll be concentrating on stanza three and stanza four. So before moving on into the stanza three, let us see the new words that comes in that stanza. Okay. So the first one is tales, stories. My dear little darlings, kindly repeat the spelling along with me. T-A-L-E-S. Tales. S-T-O-R-I-E-S. E-S, stories. Second word is robbing. Robbing means to steal, to take away from someone without even informing. So without their knowledge, if we take anything, it is robbing. Okay, repeat the word along with me, dear all. R-O-B-B-I-N-G, robbing. Third one, think to form an idea. Repeat along with me, T-H-I-N-K, think. So the meaning of think is to form an idea. Wonderful. Fourth one, wrong. Wrong meaning is not correct. So repeat with me, W-R-O-N-G, wrong, not correct. So we'll repeat from first, tales, stories, robbing, to steal, think, to form an idea, wrong, not correct. Okay, so next we'll move on to the antonyms that comes in these two stanzas. No, in the third stanza. Okay, shocking, unsurprising. Shall we repeat the spelling, my dear little ones? S-H-O-C-K-I-N-G, shocking. Unsurprising, U-N-S-U-R-P-R-I-S-I-N-G, unsurprising, wonderful. Now let us move on to the second one, robbing, R-O-B-B-I, N-G, robbing, giving, G-I-V-I-N-G, giving, true, T-R-U-E, true, false, F-A-L-S-E, false, long, L-O-N-G, long, short, S-H-O-R-T, short. Shall we repeat it from first, my dear little darlings? Yes, wonderful. I want you all to repeat along with me. Shocking, unsurprising, robbing, giving, true, false, long, short. Yes. Now we will move on to the third stanza. Shocking tales I hear of you. Chirp and tell me, are they true? Robbing all the summer long. Don't you think it very wrong? So in the previous two stanzas, we saw in the first stanza that a sparrow. It visits the poet's house, and through his or her chirping noise, she has come to ask for the food on the cold day. In the second stanza, the poet says that he has collected many crumbs and he will surely give a treat to the sparrow. And he will just stand back and watch the sparrow enjoying the food. In the third stanza, the poet is actually a little bit shocked because he hears the tales of the sparrow. Tales. My dear little ones, what is the meaning of tales? Wonderful stories. Shocking. Surprised. Yeah, the poet is very much surprised. Okay, he has heard something about the sparrow. What is that? And he is asking the confirmation from the sparrow. Come on, chirp and tell me whether whatever I have heard, are they true or false? Because birds cannot talk like us, isn't it? Their means of communication is chirping. So the poet says, whatever I have heard about you, if it is true or false, whether it is true or false, come on, chirp and tell me. So you have been robbing all the summer long? Yeah. So the poet says, all the summer you have been robbing one or the other things from others' houses. And he's also asking, don't you think robbing is wrong? So he's asking, just come on, you only justify. You have been robbing the things from others' houses throughout the summer. And don't you think whatever the work that you're doing, that is robbing, it is wrong? How beautiful. Yes. So here, yes. So this is, I is a pronoun here. Me is also a pronoun. You is a pronoun. Yes. So with this, we'll move on to the next meaning part of stanza 4. So these are the new words that we come across in the fourth stanza. So first one is steal. Okay. Steal means to take. S-T-E-A-L. Steal. To take. Now second one is wheat. W-H-E-A-T. Wheat. My dear little darlings, are you aware of what is a wheat? Yes. Wonderful. Correct. So this is the wheat. Can you tell me what do we prepare from this? Yes. Through wheat flour only we prepare chapati, puri. Great. Very good for health. Yes. And here, complain. Meaning of complain is to express pain. So let us repeat the spelling. C-O-M-P-L-A-I-N. Complain. To express pain. Fourth one is plums. My dear little ones, are you aware of what is this plum is? Have you seen it? Hey, great. It's a fruit. Yeah. So the color is exactly like an apple, but it is a plum fruit, which will have a single seed and very tasty fruit it is. Yes. And the antonyms that we see in the stanza are steal, return. Come, let us repeat the spelling. S-T-E-A-L, steal. Return, R-E-T-U-R-N, return. Second one, complain, accept. Repeat along with me, dear ones. C O M P L A I N. Complain. Accept. A C C E P T. Accept. Ripe. R I P E. Ripe. Raw. R A W. Raw. Fourth one. Share. Keep. S H A R E. Share. K E E P. Keep. Wonderful. Shall we repeat it from first? Yes. Steal. Return. Complain. Accept. Ripe. Raw. Share. Keep. Beautiful. So now let us move on to the fourth stanza. Yes. So the in the stanza, the poet says, so in the third stanza, we saw that poet has heard something about the sparrow and he wanted to know whether it was true that the sparrow has been stealing, okay, throughout the summer. So he just wanted to know whether it is true. In fourth stanza, he says, Thomas says, you steal his wheat. John complains, his plums you eat. Choose ripest for your share, never asking whose they are. So this is the complaint the poet has heard about the little sparrow. So here Thomas was there, his friend, and he has complained that sparrow keeps on stealing his wheat. What is the meaning of steal, my dear little ones? To take away. Without Thomas' permission, the sparrow has been stealing wheat. And John, the another friend of the poet, has complained that he has been eating his plums. Yeah, just now we saw the plum fruit. So, and those plum also, the ripest one. Okay, he is choosing the ripest juicy fruit and he is eating it as his own share. He is not asking anyone, nor is asking Thomas, nor is asking John. Never asking whose they are. So the sparrow is not at all worried to know whether the wheat belongs to whom or the plum belongs to whom. He's just enjoying the wheat and the plum. And also in the plum, the most ripest one he is choosing, which are very sweet and juicy. He's choosing the ripest fruit and he's just enjoying it, even not worried to whom the fruit and the wheat belongs to. Is it correct, my dear little darlings? For example, when you were in the school last year, you take your favorite dish for your short break or for your lunch. And without your permission, your friend, he or she is just taking away, robbing your box, and he or she just enjoys it, even not informing to you, not even worried about whether you are intending to eat it or give it to him or her. Without your permission, if your friend enjoys your favorite dish or your favorite snack, whatever you have brought, is that correct? Yeah, it's wrong, isn't it? Yeah, we're not supposed to do like that. But here there is a complaint that sparrow is doing such words, things. Okay, so now let us see some rhyming words of third stanza and fourth stanza. You, true, my dear little darlings, repeat with me. Y O U. You, T R U E. True. L O N G. Long. W R O N G. Wrong. wheat, wheat, eat, eat. share, share, A-R-E-R. Now let us repeat from first, my dear little ones. You, true. Long, wrong. Wheat, eat. Share, are. Wonderful. Great job, my dear little darlings. So now, I want you all to do one drawing activity, okay? So you have to draw and color your sparrow. So it is all your own creativity. Just a sample I'm sharing here. You can take the outer sketch of the sparrow and you can start coloring it. So it can be your creativity, whether you can color it with the natural colors of the sparrow or you can go on with your a lovely color, just as we saw in the video, there was a blue sparrow. But normally blue sparrows doesn't exist. It's just left to our imagination and creativity. So draw a beautiful sparrow and color it. Okay. My dear little ones, we have come to the end of today's session. Until next class, stay home, stay safe. Meet you all soon in the next class. Bye-bye.